So a prostate tumor is made up of different cells. And within these cells, a rare population of cells is responsible for the tumor relapse after treatment. These cells, look at that, one in 1,000, so really, really rare population. And these cells are called cancer stem cells. But a tumor is also surrounded by a microenvironment, which is called stroma. Interleukin-4 is a growth factor, and it helps the growth of the cells in your immune system. And the growth factor is important in the tumor in general because it enhances and improves the growth of cancer cells. So it makes cells more aggressive. In the prostate stroma, interleukin-4 is secreted by tumor-infiltrating lymphocytes that are cells of your immune system. So the first thing I did was try to find out what was the effect of IL-4 on these cells isolated directly from patients. And what I found was that in the presence of IL-4, as you can see, cells grow more. This ability is called clonogenicity. Clonogenicity is the ability of the cells to grow from a single cell. And remember that cancer cells need to be close to each other to grow. So only these cells which are able to grow from a single cell are the more aggressive cells. And this is important for the tumor spread. And remember, metastasis kill patients. So in the immune response, IL-4, to be active, needs to bind this receptor called IL-4 receptor alpha. And I screened 48 different signaling pathways, but in our model, only STAT6 in our cells was activated after IL-4 exposure. So what I did was use a STAT6 inhibitor in the presence of IL-4. And so I blocked the ability of these cells to grow faster. So why this is important? Because the current therapies only target a zone of the tumor. And but unfortunately, more than 40% of patients develop a more aggressive cancer called castrate-resistant prostate cancer. So targeting the tumor microenvironment is important to fight against this mechanism of resistance. And think about that. IL-4 is a cytokine, so it switches your immune system so your cancer can be more aggressive. And as a metaphor for you, imagine the plant as a tumor, the soil as the stroma, and the fertilizer as IL-4. If you give the fertilizer to the soil, the tumor will grow healthy. Thank you.
Sorry, question at the back. Thank you.
It's very interesting, and you mentioned that currently there is the resistance in terms of using antibiotics and medicine, and that's why you suggested IL-4, if I'm not mistaken. But is there a possibility that it'll get resistant against that as well?
This is a good question. As I told you, IL-4 is secreted by the cells of your immune system, so you can't target IL-4. The thing is that if you can target the downstream signaling pathway of IL-4, so for example STAT6, you can give time to doctors to slow down the growth of tumor so they can act and in situ. Because the thing is that when a tumor starts growing and starts becoming aggressive, the tumor just, imagine your cells are just going into your blood system, and then they can metastasize in different sites of your body. If you manage to slow down this process, you can give time to doctors to cure you. That's the point.
Jury question, thank you.
So it's a nice piece of research. What is the next stage then in terms of therapies for prostate cancer that arise from your work?
I think what I'm showing in my work is that now, at the moment, prostate cancer, current therapies, as I told you, target only a zone of the tumor. The first step of therapy is androgen ablation, because prostate cancer, so prostate cells, are androgen receptor positive. But these mechanism of resistance, these cells are not responding to androgen receptor signaling. And the thing is that the current therapies target only these kind of cells, ignoring, for example, the tumor microenvironment, which is the main source of cytokines, such as IL-4. So this is what I'm showing.
Okay, then, Giovanna, thank you very much.